Hi friends, welcome to Tutors Funny channel. Today I am going to teach how to make the vegetable shop inventory management system using Java. Let us show the demo first. Here, this is the demo. These are the vegetables available in our shop. You can easily, you have to select them. This I have put the J list, right? Now here, click on this carrot, need carrot. It asks the quantity, you have enter the quantity here. Here each price should be 12. Here calculate the total, here subtotal also calculate itself. After that here to order another item, beetroot, quantity 50, right. Here is the third one, corn, you have to enter 10, discard. Cauliflower, you have to write 19, right. It successfully, it's calculated and display the price here, right. Very simple inventory management system. Management using Java, right? I will teach how to do this system step by step. If you are newcomer of our channel, please subscribe our channel, right? Right. Now let's go to our lessons, right? First, I already opened the NetBeans. So here, go to the file, new project. Here, first select the Java application, Java application. Click next. If it is checked, create main class, you have to uncheck it. Here I am going to give the project name as vegetable shop. Shop, right. Now let's click finish. Alright, now here we have to close this one. We don't need them, we are close off, right. Okay. Now here, this is your project, has been created with the name of vegetable shop. Your project folder consists of the source packages, right. Now you have to expand the source package. Click on the default package, right click, new, create the new package, Java package as veg. Yeah, just give us veg shop. I shortly give it like this, right. Click finish, right. Now my new package has been created successfully. Select the package, right click, new, JFrame form. Here I am going to give the class name as veg shop. I just give the veg shop, right. This is the form I am going to create, right. This is the simple form, right, empty form. Now here I am going to first design them. Let's increase the size little bit, look like this. Alright, perfect. Now what I am going to do is here, first I am going to go to the palette, drag one panel on the form. We have to size look like this, right, perfect, alright. Now select this panel, right click, properties, background color, I am going to change it as 10 of the panel, right, close it. After that I drag another panel here. This is footer, select this one, right click, properties, background color, I am going to change it as to black, right, close it, perfect. Now here what I am going to do is here, first I am going to write the heading for here. So drag one label on the form, right click, here I am going to right click, properties, we have to foreground color, I am going to change it as white, then only you will be able to see the text, right, because the when you drag the label on the form, default color will be black, so that background also black, you couldn't see, so that I have change the color as white. Now you will be able to see. Now I am going to change the text, right, so click on the text and I am going to change it as a vegetable shop, vegetable shop, right. This is the heading I have wrote, right. Now let's select the heading, right click, properties, font style, select this one with bold. I am going to increase the size little bit. Let's increase as 24, right. So if you feel to increase more, little bit big, 36, right. It's okay, no problem, right. You can check, right. It's perfect. This is the heading. Now what I'm going to do is here, let's increase the size of little bit, right. Right, perfect. Now here, first what I'm going to do is here, I'm going to, second one I am going to write as here, I am drag one panel here, like this, right? This panel, right click, select this panel, properties, border property, go to the border property, select soft bevel border, click OK, close it, right? Now here inside the this panel, I'm going to drag one J label, sorry, J list, right? You can get it from the palette here, J list, here this one, J list, this one. You drag here like this. This is the simple list, right? Very simple. You have drag like this. Very simple, right? Now here default come as 1, 2, 3, 4 like this. Now I'm going to select this one. Properties, model. This is the default one. Select this one instead of that one. I'm going to paste this one. These are the vegetable available. I just wrote it. Copy this one. You have to paste it. Control V to paste it, right? Control C to copy and Control V to paste it, right? Click OK. Now if you feel to increase the size of that one, the other property called font, click on this one, you will be able to, with bold, you have to increase size as 14, click OK, right? Now if you feel to change the background color as black and font color as yellow, you will be able to see. It is very look nice. Inventory management system, if you change the color as black and yellow. So what I'm going to do is here, this one should be the default background color as white. So black color, click on this, sorry, white color, you have to make it as a black color, right? Font color, I'm going to change it as, this is a foreground color. Font, if you have to change the color as foreground, background, this is a background color. Now foreground color, select this one as a yellow. Perfect. You can give any color. It's perfect, right? It's look perfect, right? After that, we have to do another one thing is a J table, right? Now here, go to the list. We have to get one J table. This one, drag here, right? Perfect. Now to arrange it look like this, right? Perfect. Now we have to like this, right? Now we have to put like this, perfect, right? Now what I'm going to do is here. After that, select the J table, this J table. I'm going to add the header. This one should be at the column of this one, right? So select the J table, right click, table contains columns. The first one should be the item, second one should be the price, after the quantity, this one should be the total. Perfect. Select this J table again. Properties. Go to the properties, right? Go to the properties. We have to select, sorry. Select this one. Table content, sorry. Rows, select this one. Delete them. This is a default row, we no need it. Remove them. Right? This is a default row, right? You have to keep the empty one like this, right? This one empty. Now it looks perfect, right? Now what I'm going to do is here, almost our design is finished. We only do one of the things, subtotal stuff, right? So let's go to the palette, drag one label here. This one we have to change as subtotal. We couldn't see that. So let's select this one. We have to change the foreground color as this one. And we have to change it the font size as 14 with bold. Now you will be able to see that. You can see here. If you want to increase little bit more, that is 24. It's perfect. Subtotal you have to see, right? Now we need one text box field. Text field here. Text field also we have to change the color, background color as same as black. Foreground color, able to write the text as yellow, same thing. After that, for font, we have to change it as a bit bold, 24, right, perfect. Right. Now let's right click, edit text, backspace to remove the extra stent. Here, it looks perfect. Now here, what I'm going to do is it arrange like this. Let's select this one. We have to change the variable as txt sub. Perfect. Click OK. Perfect. Right. It's perfect. Now if you run the project and check what it should be here. But it is when you run the project, it is default location should be selected. So let's close then. Here we are. I'm going to select this one project. Right click properties. We have to quote generate center. If you make this option generate center, here it is working like this. Working fine. Here you will be able to select the item from the J list. Very simple, right? Now what I'm going to do is here. Let's go to the project. Here, now first I'm going to write the code stuff. So go to the source. This is the class name page shop. This is a constructor. After the constructor, we have to write below the constructor here. We have to create the default list model. This is the J list model, right? So this one should be the call it model. Equal new, we have to establish the namespace, this one showing default list model, right? So same thing, control C, copy, control V, paste here. This one, second one, we have to implement another one is a default table model. This one model one here, this time equal new, the same thing, control C, copy, control V, paste here. Right, perfect. Here also you have to implement the namespace. Right, perfect. Now what I'm going to do is here, I'm going to go to write the code for that. For when the user select the needful vegetable, so it asks a quantity. If you enter the quantity, correct quantity, the item and price and quantity, all the stuff should be display on this table, J table, right? So go to the, so what I'm going to do, select the J table, sorry, J list. This one J list, okay, not J table, J list, right? J list one is the name. Select this one, right click, event. We have to write here is event, mouse click, right? Mouse click event, right? Now here what I'm going to do is here, we have to write here is int sum equals 0. First I'm going to initialize one variable sum, right? Okay, after that I'm going to write the variable int. This one should be the vegetable, so veg equal, you write this time J list one. This is the name of the list, J list one, dot get selected index. This is the index, right? This is index property you have selected, right? What is the item you have selected here, the particular index should be displayed. This also same thing like this, a starting position should be 0, caret should be 1 2 3 4 5 6. This is how it's work, right? Okay, so what I'm going to do is here first, we have right here is if this wedge here called here equal, if it is coming 0 position mean, you have write here, sorry, 0 position mean, you have write simply in the inside this bracket, you have write here, we have to price, we have to create the variable int price, after that int quantity, qt quantity, right? Perfect. After that what I am going to do is here, we have write here is simply, you have to total also, you have to write total, right? Perfect. Now here first what I am going to do is here, price I am going to put it here is 10 each, right? So quantity we have to write, quantity I already created the variable above, you have to write here is integer dot pass int. Here we have to write here is J option pan dot show message dialog. Here first we have to show message dialog, sorry, not show message dialog, show input message dialog, sorry for that, dot show input message dialog, show input box, input dialog, this one, right? So here we have right here is enter the quantity, enter the quantity,
close error is if you have to close, sorry, we have closed one bracket here. Right, perfect. After that, what I am going to do is here, table model, right? We have created a table model here, one. This is a J table model. This is the list model, right? You have to understand that. Now here we have to get it here. Model one. Model one mean this J table, right? J table model, right? Equal, you have to write here is the same thing, default table model. Control C to copy, Control V to paste here. So here you have to write here is J table, J table 2. This one, what's the name here? J table 1 or 2? And J table 1 is a name. Right? J table 1 dot get model. This one should be the get model. Right. You have to get model. Right. Now, right. Now here what did is here we have to store this all the stuff in the J table. Right. If you select the item, it asks a quantity, give the quantity. Click OK button. It's all the things will be appended on this table, right? Calculate the price and everything, right? So here we have to calculate the price. After that, we have to write dot. We have to already create the variable here equal. How to calculate the price? Price multiplied by quantity, right? That's it. Right. After that, what I'm going to do is we have to write model one dot add row. Dot add row function. Here we have to write new object. So you have to write here object. Here write here is open and close bracket. Right. Now here we have what the things we have to write here is first we have to write what the first vegetable name. You have to write this one should be there. Carrot, Control C to copy, Control V to paste here, right, comma, right, price, second one should be the price, what is the price of that one, comma, quantity, what is the quantity, selected, after that, dot, right, so all the things should be added in this table, right, so after that, what I'm, let me check whether it's working fine or not, right. Select the carrot here, it has a quantity. If you give 2, press enter key here, carrot 10, price quantity 2, it should be multiply and display the total here successfully, right? The same task you have to do here below the item as well. So what I'm going to do is here, the same thing. We have to write the same thing. If we start position here, close bracket here, the same thing here to copy. Control C to copy, Control V to paste here. Second one should be else if vegetable 1 mean, this one 1 mean, if it is result is come 1 mean, beetroot, right? So second one should be the beetroot. Control C to copy. Here I am going to put this one as a beetroot. Control V to paste here. This one I can change the price butter, right? I just give as 40, right? That's the stuff we have to do. Only there we have to change the price and name of the vegetable, right? Now the same else if you have to copy, Control C to copy, Control V to paste here. This one should be 2. 2 mean third one, 2, right? Because starting position should be 0, right? Right. Now third one cauliflower, right? Here we have to go to, I just copy this one. If I write those stuff, it takes too much time to complete the video, so that I just wrote it as a notepad, right? Control V to paste here. This one, I just change it as a 16, right, it's a cauliflower, price should be, same thing, you have to Control C to copy, Control V to paste the remaining steps, 3, this one 3, so this one should be 3, after that, corn, this one should be the corn, here that corn, right, this one should be a 17, so same thing, Control C to copy, Control V to paste, this one 4 mean this one, 4, mushroom, third one, corn, mushroom, third one, mushroom, right, for mushroom, so we have to copy this one, Control C to copy, this one, mushroom, right here, price we have to change, just this one, 20, we have to just change it as 20, same else if, Control C to copy,
Control V to
paste below. This one should be fifth one. You have to change it as 25. Here we have to change it as a potato. Control C to copy, Control V to paste. Right. Right. Final stuff is this one. Control C to copy, Control V to paste here. This one should be 6. So we have to increase the price little bit. 30. Just increase as 30. Right. After that, what I am going to do is here. We have to pumpkin. Control C to copy, Control V to paste. Perfect. This is the thing you have to do. Right? Okay.
This is the only simple stuff you have to do. Very simple. Right. Everything is fine.
Okay. Right.
Now let's check whether it's working fine or not.
Carrot. Beetroot. Cauliflower. Corn. Mushroom. Potato, pumpkin. Here it's added successfully, right? Now after that, finally we have to calculate the subtotal as well, right?
So how to calculate the subtotal is very simple.
Finally, after the else if, it is this else if is starting and close it here, right? Bracket is, you must consider the bracket where I started, where I close, right? Okay, after that, this bracket is closed, we have to write a for loop. So we have to calculate them. For initial variable I equals 0. After that, we have to write I here. We have to write here j table 2, sorry, 1. What is the name of the j table? It's 1. Dot get row count. After that, I plus plus, right? This is how we have to calculate the subtotal, right? Right. Now here we have, right? We already create the sum variable above. We already create the sum variable above. We have to get it them here. Sum equals sum plus integer dot pass int. Here we have, right? J table 1 dot get value at i3 mean the column should be starting 0 position, 1 2 3, third position. Perfect. Finally, we have to write a two string method. That's why this take error, right? Now finally you have to write, it's, what is the name of this one? Total should be txt sub. Result should be this pair, txt sub dot setx. Right here is sum. This one call it here. So we have right here string dot value of, we have to write this sum. Control C to copy, Control V to paste here. Right, perfect. Now it's all the stuff should be working fine. Now let's check subtotal display successfully or not. Let's run the program and check. So beetroot 4, cauliflower, right here it's working fine, right? Very simple inventory management system in Java, in Vegetable Shop. You must try this one, you will be able to do. If you like my channel, please subscribe me, like me. Thank you for watching.